Today, we are alleging that November's Florida Senate District 37 election involved crimes.
Miami-Dade state attorney says disgraced lawmaker Frank Artilla has masterminded a plot to help a Republican win a key Florida state Senate seat.
He knew then, and we are alleging that he knows now, that he was blatantly thumbing his nose at the law.
Last November, incumbent Democrat Jose Javier Rodriguez lost his Senate seat by just 32 votes, a race that he tells CNN he would have won.
There's no question that this had an impact on a race that was ultimately decided by 32 votes out of nearly a quarter million cast.
But Jose Javier Rodriguez lost. There was a third candidate, a sham candidate in this race, with the same last name as his, who siphoned away Democrat votes. Alex Rodriguez, who's also charged in the plan.
We've been looking for Alex. Is he around?
No. He'll be back tomorrow, though.
That's actually Alex Rodriguez behind the door, lying to a reporter from CNN affiliate WPLG about his own identity last year. Alex Rodriguez told officials Frank Artilla paid him nearly $45,000 to be a so-called ghost candidate. He was promoted as a liberal in advertising mailers, but never campaigned and never debated.
In addition to the same surname, there was a very well-orchestrated and funded last-minute campaign to persuade voters and, frankly, trick them.
While entering a sham candidate into a political race isn't a crime, the funding of one is, according to prosecutors. Both Artiles and Rodriguez are charged with three felonies each.
What is a crime is making illegal campaign contributions to get a candidate to run.
The Republican challenger who won the election by just 32 votes is Ileana Garcia, a founder of Latinas for Trump. Prosecutors say there's no evidence she knew anything about the plot to get her elected. Her spokesperson telling CNN she's never even met Frank Artiles. Artiles' attorney tells CNN his client is cooperating and we fully intend to defend any charges in court. This case is part of a pattern CNN previously reported last year. Three races with ghost candidates supported by political action committees that all registered at the same time and had similar donations and similar spending on nearly identical mailers.
There was also hundreds of thousands of dollars of dark money. We still don't know where it came from, sending mailers to voters in the district to confuse them with Democratic-leaning messages.
Wolf, Alex Rodriguez's attorney says his client deeply regrets being used in this way for this election. As for Frank Artiles, he's got a history of controversies. He had to resign his own state Senate seat back in 2017 after using racial slurs in front of two black lawmakers and hiring a Hooters calendar girl and a Playboy model as political consultants.